Welcome, dear friends of Tactical Gameplay, to another episode of Xenonauts X Division with me, Dagger. Yeah, as promised, I got the next ground mission prepared, so also just dropped their stuff. Lucy Cook couldn't resist turning, or I couldn't resist turning her, or I was too unconcentrated, however you want to put it. I generally like that starting area on that map, because it's pretty enclosed. You can easily smoke the three entrances there are. Yeah, the only problem can occur when there's aliens in here, but it doesn't seem that way. Farmer there, with his shotgun pointed in our direction. We're not the enemy's boy. No one there, no one there, okay. Let's scout a bit more here. Okay. Don't have any clue yet what we are up against here. Oh, Drake Harris actually isn't Sheila. Yeah, I'm. With this and the Corvette mission, which is upcoming, I totally missed to swap around the team so the Sheilas are at the doorways, which is a bit unfortunate. But okay. Ooh, Sophie Fischer even has multiple smoke grenades. Nice. Okay. Well, I'll say it's close enough. We'll put her in front of the rifleman here. And of these guys, Lars won't be doing anything this turn anyway. So we can throw smoke out here. And then we'll assign Maxime here, to smoke duty in this direction. And then we have a decent smoke screen. and by the way, at the beginning of the Let's Play, I claimed that I wouldn't ever smoke unless I knew where the aliens were, but you see I'm standing corrected. I'm doing it now, just because we were carrying sufficient amounts of smoke, in my opinion, that I can do that. And it's a nice conservative way to start a mission, especially when you have a nice compound like this. Let's get you there. Sophie can take one more step here. I'm eager to learn what we are up against this mission. Maxime should still get a step back. Yeah, so the question is, where do we put our... I mean, I want one suppression in the center, but that's also already the hunter, so maybe Lars will take this direction and Farrelly will take the one down here. Doesn't sound too unreasonable. Yeah, 3, 3, and 3. Okay, we have seasons again, which is nice, but I still don't have my cheat sheet. Although somewhere in the process of moving I saw it briefly, but I didn't remember to hold on to it. So there's that. Okay, let's quickly check with Minoru. Oh, by the way, it's the first night mission of the campaign. And we have two enemies at once. Wow, okay. That's pretty luxurious, because we can easily suppress them both with one salvo, I think. Nope, we can't. But we have a second shot here. Not a single hit. I mean, was it impossible for you? No, it wasn't. Oh, blocked 100%. Okay, maybe it was. Maybe if I had shot there, it would have strayed. I think that's technically possible. So, with the first two enemies revealed here, let's get started trying to flank them. Okay, nothing in the immediate vicinity here. But let's be cautious about this, because it's still a couple of tiles here. And we have decent cover here, so we can afford to scout around a bit more. Plus the squad isn't ready to engage in this direction anyway. At least Drake Harris and Lars Lunde still have to get close. Can you throw smoke for 44? Wow, perfect, okay. Let's do. Not so good a position. Oh yeah, you were one of the guys with abysmally low time units. With Potato having started his new campaign and laying the emphasis on bravery and time units, I can totally understand him. Because time units are among the most valuable thing you can have. Okay, so our shielder here is preoccupied with her own mind. Yeah, her own mind. This is actually a nice area for scouting without a shield, because you can keep behind the high cover and do you have smokes? Yes. Okay. And still decently scout in that direction. In any direction, I wanted to say. Okay, so they are here, which means I A, don't want the scout car to be blown up, obviously, which means we'll put more smoke in front of it. Okay. Ah, decent enough, I hope. And B will position Maxime here. So the shield and him will engage in this direction with the scout car, and these four will go around here and fall on their backs. Maybe. That's the plan. Okay, this one runs back. This was a farmer running disoriented through the smoke. Let's be kind of smart about that and take a bit of a corner here. So we know he went back around here. We know there's nothing there, and this compound is, I think, really long and without... Oh, these bushes are actually cover. Sorry. Oh, there he is. Hey. Let's see if we can get a chance to take him through the wall. Yes, we can. And these ambient sound sometimes really scary. Sometimes just annoying. Sometimes really thematic. Okay, so Sophie Fischer will go here. We'll need some smoke in that direction to cover our backs. Who can do this? Lars Lunde's out of smokes, it seems. Drake Harris can theoretically do it, but he doesn't have time units to speak of. Wow. And then it still costs 23 to throw. I'll try it. Okay, good enough. Good throw. But now you're totally out, and Lars Lunde has to run around you. But what can you do? And Filda. Filda will maybe even go more to there. They can't throw grenades, even if they knew how clustered we were. And yeah, I'm more concerned about anything from that direction. So, maybe it would have been smarter to only leave like one guy or two here to have the rest come this direction. Which we may incidentally just do. Okay, you can't even see that. But you could throw a flashlight. Oh, then no, you can't. Okay, Maxime, maybe. Yeah. Hello. Yeah, so in case I'm the only Xenonauts player you're watching, in night missions you have these little lights, and you have the lights from the hunters and a bit light from your people. So these ones essentially service as extensions of your impaired sight range from the fact that it is dark. Okay, I don't like that these two don't have a shield here, but I'm confident enough that if I use them defensively, we'll make it. Okay. Oh, Xenomorph! Let the clubbing begin. Put your gun the other way, dude. Okay, so it should go down with 2 to 3 hits from stun shock batons. The question is if these two soldiers can manage to get these hits onto it. Oh, okay, now it's less because it shot the Seasonier shot his own. The other one didn't move, so maybe we'll again suppress them both. Let's actually check the corner like this with a bit of ring around. Yeah, he's suppressed. Okay, so we know that for now. To bring the scout car up a bit so the way is clear for them to riot prod the hell out of that thing. And the plan is that they then will run into this corridor here where, apart from. No, it even came out of the barn, I think. What do you see? Oh, another one in there. Okay. That changes things a bit. Yeah, so let's kill one. Kill one and stun the other one, maybe. I mean, essentially, as long as no one explodes them near to us, we should be good taking one round of hits from them because the armor still has to be whittled down first. So yeah, let's risk it. I really want those close range weapons. One smoke grenade too much to just change the weaponry out. And you can't do a second one, no. 2 and 6 and 2 steps. So let's hope that you can actually do 2 hits. Wow, you have a shotgun, eh? Yeah, I loaded the good brand new shotguns. Come on. Don't disappoint me. You disappointed me. That's bad. Okay. So what we now essentially have to do is at least kill that one or at least make sure he doesn't do anything in some other way. Maybe a grenade is in order. because I don't use them too often. Drake Harris has some, but we'll really have to watch how much that costs, because he can't walk. Okay, that is. You can throw in there, you can throw here. Okay, with 111%. Let's do that. Okay, that one was splattered. And the other one. For the sake of light fibers, do we want to capture it? It isn't wounded yet. Nah, let's just kill it, because we have these two still to worry about. Anyone other than Lars Lunde deserving the kill? Do we want to keep the shield? Is the question, because we could go around him with Sophie. Blast him in the back once, then with Pilda from the front again. Yeah, let's try it. Let's play a bit of ping-pong here. You have 21 time units. If you turn now, you still have only one shot. So you can go here and do that. And then let's hope Pilda can clear the situation. No, she can't. So Lars will be it. Or does Pilda still have a shot? No. With a shotgun, maybe? It's like 18% of time units. So if I drop that, that doesn't cost anything, that costs 4. So we have 8 of 74, and that is way more than 18%. Plus we'd then to start getting through the kinetic armor, which we didn't start yet. Okay, so we have these two left. They can't really aid for now in combating these, unless everything here is clear so far. Then they can start moving up at least. Or provide more coverage or something like this. Okay, everything's clear so far. How far can you move? Oh, this is actually not the bugged building, because there is one where you can't move through there. Okay, you can walk to there at least. And Farrelly can't provide you with smoke. I don't really like it, but two people here is too few. Let's do it. I'm really disappointed that we didn't get this one with 3 hits, because I have succeeded in that multiple times, I think, now. Over my Xenonauts or X-Division plays. And I think it never took more than 3 hits, because their hit points are just so low. Okay, they don't gang up. That's good. But what does this one do? Is he considering? Okay. And there was some shot somewhere. From a laser gun. Okay, so now we should actually be able to down him. This one was the one from there, was it? No, oh yeah, it was. Come on, just go down. Yeah, it's easier that way. And oh, we have a normal shotgun on Minoru Hara. Don't I have enough division shotguns, or do I just... Wow, that's the kind of stun damage I'm talking about. That's the kind of stun damage where you only need 3 hits. Yeah, let's bring Farrelly up. He should have a stick as well, because I took to great lengths securing that everyone has a stick now. Ah, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm used to. And not like 5 hits like the other one. But I mean, there was a 6 and a 4 or whatever in there, so maybe it was not too surprising. Ah, your inventory is total garbage. Let's do it like that for now. Don't need any of these items necessarily. And that way you can at least save some time units and get back into cover there. Maxime, you don't have smoke. Huh. Also garbage inventory. Let's do it like this for now. Maybe we'll come back to picking it up later. That's the next thing I'm gonna have to work on. Oh, there's a smoke grenade there, but if you go there now, then turn around and throw smoke, you'll be the one in the position where I didn't want anyone to be. Yeah, okay, so let's accept the positions we're in here and hope for the best. Nothing I'd advise you to do. But I mean, what could possibly happen? I just lost a lieutenant, so... back around the corner. Okay. So we're pretty safe-ish here. We may be ambushed here, actually. But let's play it safe for this turn and... at least get cover here, so if anything comes here, it doesn't see us. Technically, we should still check the upper floors. Let me maybe see if I can see some bleeding farmer, because that's a good indication of where the... or maybe a good indication of where the laser shot actually came from. Actually, since we have the scout car here, let's put it as a as our rear guard here. Because with it at least we can see if anything comes from there. We should still clear that house, but we are around here for like 2 or 3 turns and there's nothing been coming out. And a couple of civilians running about there. Oh, you still have your stick in hand. Take your pistol back up. Good job on the clubbing. Yeah, we need to... or at least I'd like to... like, cover this field. I mean, it's abysmal in terms of movement and cover. It's just really bad for us, especially in the night conditions. Wow, good throw. Yeah, but at least like that we check that no one's immediately near, or doesn't seem so. So that's that. And let's bring Maxime in a bit better position, like that. And that will be it for the turn. Still a Scion, still some phaser rifle stuff. These ones are not bleeding, so it doesn't seem to be in the house. Who's in the house? Ah, UFO is here as per usual with this map. Which means that the shooting should maybe occur somewhere around here instead. But let's actually... you don't have many time units left. Still not seeing further. I mean, there has to be something here. Is it a wall? Pretty much has to be the wall. Yeah, let's get you here for now. Bit of smoke left. Last doesn't have any. Filter may be able to throw some through that window if she has some left. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, never send soldiers alone, obviously. Yeah, good one. Good throw. You can even secure the entrance with reasonably high probability. Ah, let's do it like this. Perfect. Good. And now let's bring Lars up here too. And maybe let's also bring the other shield around. I mean, it's not like she'll do anything in the... let's actually leave her there. This one's cowering, but I think that doesn't count for much. That's bad. I should have thought about that prior to moving him. Her. And Farrelly will take position here. And Maxime is the one with decent time units. We'll come here. The scout car will go a bit back. Just because there's the entry. No laser fire now. I'm curious. Skotka has 115 hit points. Oh, there's one. Perfect. Suppressed and hit for a good chunk. Through his shield, essentially. Not through, but to the side. So this was the one firing, I'm pretty sure now. So with that knowledge, I am prepared to risk going out here. But maybe not so much out there that we can't get our soldier back into cover. Lars, you come here. Time for the next lieutenant to go. No, just kidding. Would be pretty furious if that were to happen right now. Okay, good enough for me. So, seems there's nothing here. So we can start getting around the side of the UFO next turn here. Actually, we can consider positioning Lucy Cook up there right now. And fairly to the back there, maybe. I mean, then he can't suppress the alien, which he could if he were to be here. But we also don't want the alien to shoot on at him. Maxime, how far can you go? Yeah, you can go there. Perfect. Then you do that. Performer, keep an eye to the back. No O'Hara comes here. We may actually... no, he should have taken one step back, but now it's now he has too little time units anyway. Let's maybe try to get that light out there anyway. Yeah, like this. Ah, perfect. Okay, doesn't get us vision on the AN, but at least it gives us some vision. We'll know if he comes up, because I intend to have Sophie stay in that corner. Filderstair has to come back. I'm not checking the barn anymore, or the house for that matter. If you want to play perfectly safe, you should do it, because there may be lurkers around. But, I mean, I've heard no casualties in there, no shotgun shooting or whatever. Which would be the typical implications of, hey, there's something bad in there. That's okay. Is she in the line of fire if Faraday comes around and suppresses it now? I'm asking because I want the scout car to suppress the front door if I can. And also I don't want it to take any more hits. I think that should be somewhat possible. And you now come here. You suppress it. Perfect. Scout car comes out somewhere here. Now lay fire to the door. Maybe suppress anything inside. And then the question becomes, where can it hit us? Can we hit it from here? Nope. Okay. So I'm inclined to say we're safe there. I want more smoke out there. One on him. Lucy has two left. Okay. Yeah, let's try to chuck it there. Where did it land? Okay. Don't pack them together, because any time anything might come out and throw a stun grenade at them. Filter now. Wow. She's really... I mean, she's a lieutenant. Come on. Don't be so bad at bravery. Drake Harris, the man with the sore legs. I'm pretty sure I never stop joking about him. Unless he's dead and I forget about him. Maybe then. And Laszlo can just come up now. I don't think there's anything back there. Minoru Hara is still here. Could still go somewhere. Yeah, let's do it. Let's put him there. And the scout car will just stay where it is. Maxim didn't do much, so he may reaction fire to the backs of our shielders, which would be awful. Let's first of all suppress the door. Maybe it'll even suppress him. Nope, it doesn't. Let's do it again. Yep, now he's suppressed. Now we'll go for a close quarters kill. Who needs more accuracy? 57... 41, Lucy Cook is a candidate here. Can we play ping pong? Only at most once. He was already hit for like 34, so maybe once suffices. But then she's here with one time unit. Oh well, she's at least turned in the right direction. Lucy would be here. 19-9, turning to the door, but still she's a sure target. And 9 doesn't afford to turn one step and then turning towards the door. That is pretty awful. We should not do that. But I want him dead. And I want the privates to gain some stats. Who else is awful at shooting? 57 for a sergeant, come on. Ah, that's more like it. Fairly is good enough. Yeah, let's Maxime with the second shot, I mean. 20, then he stands in front of the gates with almost no time units left. Ah, he may make it into cover. Or we'll put the shield in front of him. Yeah, let's try it like that. Wow, only 8. Ah, because we hit him with the scout car before. Should still be a safe thing from here. Okay. So, can you go there? Yes, you barely can. So we'll put Lucy Cook there, you go in behind there, you turn around to there. And now we need smoke. Minoru. You still have smoke, perfect. How much does it cost to throw? 28, good. So from here you can throw one. Also good. Oh, it destroyed something in there. Okay. And the other ones will get closer. Maybe provide some covering fire, actually. Just so the aliens are not too fearsome coming out there. I mean, the only one capable of doing that is Filler. And it's through thick smoke, but maybe the AI doesn't know that. I don't know. We'll see. Oh, we have left someone. The slowest one. Did you panic? No. Okay, nothing happened. Good. We didn't even hear a door, which is an indication, but no proof that there's nothing in there. Let's group up around the UFO now. Suppress with the scout car once more. At least one rifleman over there. Minoru Hara has all his shots still. So you come here. Who did we leave? Because now it's 3-3 plus him. 2 are here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I can count, okay. Maxime can still go over there. Yeah, and then we'll have 4-4. Like that, Sophie Fischer hunkers, so these guys, at least Maxime can shoot over there. Maybe you go back 2 tiles. I enjoy the symmetry there. And you come up closer. You go there. Nah, I pretty much think it's nonsense to cover there. To cower. To worker can get exactly one salvo out. First seasons it's always a bit more risky because... Oh, we didn't even check for stun guns, damn it. There may be some lying around. Thus, why don't you go check the map? This one exploded, but there's one back here-ish. That is still quote-unquote intact. Intact. Oh. Okay, still nothing there. Let's see what this one had. I think it fired some normal laser, phaser, whatever weaponry at us. And I think these and this one were the only ones we've seen. So let's check this one. Oh, he only has a phaser also. And he has a pretty good shield, so one of our shield gets considerably lower. You may want to take that. So let's wait until next turn with storming the UFO. It's maybe also already risk bringing the shielders closer one tile, because the scout car is pretty accurate and also we can have it drive forward a bit. We should even break the fence now I'm thinking about it. So our soldiers can retreat if they have to. No one's coming out. Lars gets back to his weapon. And I dropped it there so he can pick up any lightning rifle we were to encounter, obviously. He's playing the stuff. Ah, I knew it. It was risky. Fylda, why are you panicking? They don't even do anything right now. Not even with mind tricks. Okay. So, I want to look now, even though Fylda is out of action and she's a good soldier. Ooh! Okay. So this is a normal one, right? Yeah, this is a normal guard we can execute. And these are like an engineer and a scion. They both give 1000 credits. This one gives 8 light fibers if we stun it. But I'm intent on stunning the green one because we may not have that. I don't know exactly what it is. But I'm happy to kill the other ones. Scion. Did we research the Scion? If so, it would have been really early. Let's actually capture the Scion. The privates don't have shotguns. Who has? Maxime has one. Fylda has another, I think. Minoru has a normal one. Yeah, Fylda has the other good one. And Drake Harris has a normal one. Okay. So, I don't want to necessarily break the shields, but I'm considering that one shotgun shot from the back might actually kill them. First of all, I clear as day want to kill this one, because I mean I get the fibers from anywhere essentially. Okay. No. Again, we're in trouble because I can't handle time unit stuff. Let's be smart about that here. Or let's at least try to for once. I want to check what's in there, obviously. Okay, nothing there. Nothing there. Oh, there are two dead ones from the crash. So if we go here with him, he has at least two shots with a shotgun. We can first of all try it on the Scion, because Scion's always there. We could try to shoot at the Scion from here, which would also hurt him and turn him around, and that would give us more options from where the bunch of soldiers are. Let's try that. And also I want to possibly... No! Damn it! Didn't mean that button. Okay. No, yeah, no, yeah, no, yeah. No misclicks now, please. Okay, that's hard. Okay. I don't know if that was an execution or not. But now we need smoke here and a shield in front of him. Still, please, not the wrong button. Minoru Hara has still another shotgun, but first let's... Come on. Can you go there? Yes, okay, perfect. You come here. Can you at least throw smoke? Not with 14 time units, you can't. Drake Harris can't because he's slow. We could actually at least take a shot on him. So we may be able to shotgun him from here. I mean, it's more damage. And more damage isn't ideal, but I'm out of options to clap him this turn, I think. So let's do it like this. Sophie, you can't throw smoke, you can't run in this turn, so you can as well kill it. And now Minoru or Farrelly will throw smoke. Farrelly can easily do it. And then the reactor might blow up. We'll see. Yeah. Flimsy things there. Okay. Well, not too happy about the crouching thing, but what can you do? Let's actually have him stand up at least. And have you turn inwards. And we'll see what comes through the door. Nothing for now, okay. Surprising. If you open the door, you should still be able to burst. Which would be good. Wanna bring the other shielder in, of course. This one is a corpse, okay. But he has a lightning weapon. Then again, in this room they tend to stay in one of these corners. And then you don't have a chance with the lightning stuff unless you break the shield. Which likely isn't going to happen. This one should be dead anyway. Let's suppress the door. And then let's get closer to it. Maybe not too close. I think this is the tile that is not in smoke, which is unfortunate. Not next to that thing, but maybe one tile off, like that. And then the other ones... Oh! Again, I put Laszlo in a bad situation. Let's put you there then. And the other one's more to the back. Farrelly may be able to provide more smoke. 45% chance to block, okay. Good one. You can't go in there because Maxime stands there. Shotgun is a good choice all over inside the UFO. So let's just have you keep it, Strike Harris can now check this one. Which was it? Technician, we already have one, I'm pretty sure. Let's put you here. And then Fida will come up to the door, and Inoha also. And so we have this staggered approach. But if anything comes through there now, it would be pretty much bullet hell. Okay, now let's put you here. Oh, hello. You are like the commandy one, right? The scout operator. I'm pretty sure we have one of them, the light scout and the scout, but I'm not too sure if we have both actually. I'm inclined to go close and shotgun him. Suffer the reaction fire because I think he also has just a lightning weapon. Drake Harris has the normal shotgun, right? Yeah. When the shield's away, we can take up one of the lightning pistol things with someone else, like Farrelly. Get close and just stun it. It would be wisest to suppress it first, but I'm not too fond of also suppressing Sophie. And I'm also not too fond of killing it. Pulling Sophie back here is also a bit risky because of the detonator thingy here. Yeah, it has a pistol, it should react pretty quickly. But that also means it should have also even reacted when we opened the door. Which one is worse accuracy? You. So maybe you just draw its fire, so we don't have to suppress it. Zap, zap, zap. Okay. Maybe a bit more. We have more in you. I think these were actually four shots, which means the magazine should be empty. Okay, now we have broken the shield. Now we can take up one of the lightning weapons. Lars Lund is here and looking good for it. Let's pack that. Oh no, it's a phaser. Okay. Let's pack that in the backpack because we have to. Let's get that weapon. How close can you get it there? You still have 71, yeah, okay. Get it here. Drop it. Shouldn't take more than the four shots in there. More like two. Now you're carrying too much. But you only have to get like there and maybe there to be sure. Oh, why can't I click on that tile? Oh, because there's the reactor thing. Okay, so we'll have to make do from here. What? Was it the door frame? How much does it cost you? 21. So putting it on the ground and stepping aside should still be a thing. I'm not sure if I missed twice now. Or what happened there. You go there. I don't want to drop. Oh no, I'm pretty sure actually that our weapons are collected. Now that I think about it. Ah, damn it. Okay, Fisher can move away. You can come here. Now it should be sure hits. Okay. And I hope that was the last one. It wasn't, hey! Fairly, you'll have to go out of the way there. Okay. I was playing under the assumption that it was the last alien. Which it apparently wasn't. Fun times. And now I've positioned my soldiers. No. I can still. No, I can't cross it. Nobody can cross it. Okay, let's at least put a shotgun there. Okay, that could spell really big doom on our guys. But at least we can get Filda, our second shotgun, in there. And I want her to provide more smoke into that area there. Wow, the door broke with that. I mean, that's not too bad for us, but I didn't expect to open it right now. Drake Harris, where's your gun? It's in your backpack. Yeah. Oh, there is even another dead one, but it looks like a laser rifle. We may want to check with Minoru. Yeah, that's a big laser gun. Okay. I essentially don't want you to shoot, so we'll turn you away. You also don't necessarily want you to shoot. Let's waste your time units a wee bit. Now we'll turn. Damn it. Like that. Okay, and now let's weather the storm. Okay, there's the guard in there. It's run away, thankfully, but I can't see anything here. There should still be the laser battery here, so we may be able to reload that thing. Then again, I don't really care because, yeah, as I said, in there, it's really hard to even get an A in. What is there in the way now? I'm really confused. Is it because Maxime is standing there? Where's your gun? Where is your gun, soldier? I can't see anything. I think we dropped it here. Yeah, okay. So take that, turn around. This is the door, so we'll... no, we'll not suppress in there because that would blow up the thingy there. But what we'll do is have the shielders stand next to the door. Have shotgunners stand somewhere there. Lars Lunde has his gun in his backpack. You can equip it and get into some kind of whatever position. Where's Filda? Filda is here, right? Yeah, we'll have to power through his shield, sadly. You can let go of these. We'll keep your laser rifle for now. Because I think Filda will be one of the ones storming. Okay. On the one hand, if he comes out now, maybe bad for us. Because of grenades, but on the other hand, we have enough guys and we have medkits and we have enough reflex shots, so it should be okay. Yeah, didn't expect him to come out. Okay, who don't we need here? We don't need two minigunners. And why? Because this thing is in the way. I always forget that. Okay. Who has more time units of you? You. You open the door. You. Do you have a grenade, by the way? No. May also blow up the interior stuff. Okay. Are you done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That sounds like the MG-esque weapon of them. If I Oh Gott. Let's try to clear the place here. You over there. You here. Blocked by the shield only. So we'll put her forward. You. That closes it. Good. No wounds. One corporal. Ah, even the kill on Sophie Fischer didn't bring her up to rank, but it gave her some accuracy. Lucy Cook got some bravery. Filda got some bravery from freaking out. Yeah, overall pretty good. Scout operator. We captured. Well, we captured? Because it maybe was unconscious from the crash or stuff like that. Xenomorph drones. Two. Yes, good. Yeah, this stuff is pretty standard. Okay, so that was a reasonably short episode for my playstyle. And we'll have the next one in a short second. It means now, because we have the Corvette. Or the, yeah, it was the normal Corvette, because I managed to drown the bomber Corvette. But I wouldn't, maybe I wouldn't have been able to shoot it down if I had waited till it was over land, but that depends on the course. I mean, I tried it here. And we have a defender with the laser gunny thing. Okay, so that's the setup for the next mission. Hope to see you then. Bye bye, and take care.